All right, you may have been noticing some hazier, maybe smokier skies over the valley, depending on where you live this week. And that smoke is drifting in from a fire that's burning in the northern coast of California. It's called the Six Rivers Complex Fire. It's burning in Humboldt and Trinity counties.
And that fire likely started because of dry lightning. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman joining us now. And Heather, this is just one example of why it's important to understand dry lightning patterns.
Yeah, it's a great example because even though the fire is hundreds of miles away, it has a broad impact throughout the valley. It's long been understood that lightning is a real concern for fire starts, especially this time of the year when fuels are extremely dry. But making specific forecasts for dry lightning is tricky. There's a lot of variables involved. Dmitri Kalashnikov is working on bettering those forecasts with his work at Washington State University. He says the frequency of lightning started fires makes them really important to understand.
People start more fires than lightning, but the second largest cause is lightning, and lightning fires generally burn more area. Typically, a human ignition is just one spot, one fire. Lightning can strike dozens, hundreds of locations, starting simultaneous wildfires, which can be really taxing for fire response.
Kalashnikov has been working with 34 years worth of lightning and precipitation data to look for specific weather patterns that may be more likely to cause dry lightning. He's also developing a sort of climatology that could help outline where and at what point in the year dry lightning might be more likely to occur.
By doing a study like this, we now show, okay, these are the conditions and these are the weather patterns which we know can cause dry lightning. So we can look at how that climatology might change of these large-scale patterns in the future.
But Kalashnikov notes one very important finding with this work. Even in an otherwise quiet lightning season or in an area where dry lightning may be unusual, lightning outbreaks can still occur. And when they do, so can large fires. We saw proof of that in 2008 and again in 2020 with the CZU complex fire.